Nerding Swiski intro. Systems online. Launching new color mode. Now displaying Blade Runner 2049. Download complete.
Is this all a little bit too overkill? This is debatable. Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to talk about breeding for profit with Dean. So let's see what he has to say.
Pretty cool, huh?
Those are pretty neat.
And even with a gold Sharpie.
So today, I'm coming to Aquarium Co-op with my Aquarium Co-op swag on to bring them some fish. And in this case, we'll get some close-ups later, but these are the L333 plecos. This is basically how I pack them to bring them to the store. You know, the bag will start tighter, but it loses a little bit as we go.
How many are in here?
There's 10 in there.
10, huh?
And you know, where I come from, I'm about an hour away, so I don't really need to worry about oxygen or anything like that. I try to get here in that hour. Poop in the bag, these will probably go right in the store tank because our water is so similar. And I usually don't have any problems like you might have getting stuff from overseas and stuff where you have to put it in these quarantine. What? These look kind of cool.
They're autos.
Are these black autos? Regular
They're
autos.
Just regular common autos.
Yeah.
So did you choose this fish to breed out of all plecos?
Okay, so this has an interesting story behind it because I didn't actually choose this fish. Back in the old days, like say two and a half years ago, Corey actually used to work in the shop. He got six of these in and he called me up. He says, hey, I think we should do these plecos. We can make some money on them, you know, and we look at making money together. He sells them, I sell them to him. We both end up happy, right? So I came up and there was six. I took six of them home. I grew them for 2.5 years. Now that's one thing that a lot of people will not do. They will not take the time to grow out a fish, especially when you're talking about a more expensive fish. They get bored or they get impatient. They might try to push it too hard to grow it too fast and kill it that way by bloating it all the time. I just was patient with them, had them in the bottom of my angelfish tanks for a while, fed them really well, and eventually I ended up with five. So I did lose one along the way. It's gonna happen with fish, you're gonna lose some. And out of those five, I ended up with three males and two females. They all went into a 20 long, breeding for profit size tank, it's really good. I ended up with them spawning alternately. Almost every week I had a clutch of eggs. The L number plecos do not lay 140 eggs like a bristlenose will. They lay 15, you know, 10, 12. The highest number I ever had with one spawn is 22 eggs. That also is one of the things that drives the price of these fish. Is that, you know, they're not prolific. I mean, you're not like getting thousands of babies out of a pair. You're getting a few babies. They L333s are a meat eater. They will do some algae, but mostly meat. However, I did notice just the other day, as an experiment, I threw a slice of zucchini in with a bunch of fry, and they were on it like crazy.
All right,
fish.
Speaking of breeding fish for profit, here's another fish you breed for profit, right? But these are adults.
These are adults, yeah. Okay, so these are the super red koi angels.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm working more and more at getting the what I call the white coloration out of them. I want them to be more red and with the black. So typically, when I spawn these, I will hold back 15, 20 fry about twice a year to grow up for my next generations. And I will separate those at maybe dime size. So I'm picking the best color at dime size to keep. They don't always turn out that way. Sometimes the ones I pick are not the best color or don't turn into the best breeders. And then obviously, you know, if I'm keeping 15 or 20 and let's just say I get out of 20, let's say I get 18 to adult size, that's always going to be too many for me. So as time goes on, I'll bring a few to the store. Not only do they sell well, they also help selling the babies well.
So would you recommend doing angels as a breeding fish for profit, or as a first, you know, fish to breed for profit, or would you do like guppies? Would do guppies.
If you're starting out, you want to do a live bear, or an easy egg layer to raise, where you don't need a ton of extra tank space. With guppies, you know, you can breed those for profit in a 20-gallon tank. You can constantly have babies. You can constantly be netting out fish for sale, or, you know, or taking to the store for credit to help pay for the rest of your hobby. When you're talking about angelfish and cichlids, then you're talking about hundreds of babies at a time that you have to manage, and you might have to split them between several tanks as they're growing so that they're not out competing each other for food, and so you always have some available for sale. Also, with larger spawns, larger tanks, more water changes, more food. So
there goes all your profit.
Yeah, right. So I think you should get used to it with a simpler fish. And not that guppies and stuff that are simple, but they do breed themselves, basically. So you know how Corey does this, right? I rubber band these so tight that it will not pop off. My temperature and water is very, very similar to the store.
So that's why you do the whole water.
Yeah, so.
Because people are gonna ask.
Yeah, so normally, you know, Corey would be pouring these through a net. These have had about a 50% water change with fresh water before, I mean, right in the bag. So when I netted them, I add fresh tap water with some prime in it to come to the store.
Okay, let's do it.
Okay, let's do this. L333 King Tiger Plecos.
You guys find this stuff?
I'll probably drop the light in. I've never done this before.
Oh, he's gonna drop the lid in.
The lid, whatever it is.
Take a look at those guys before they all hide.
The temperature here is almost exactly as what's in the bag. So I think we're good. You ready to go?
Yep.
Always make sure you have everything out of the bag before you throw it away. Who wants this?
It's a special Dean bag.
How come you don't
Dean
have bag. Your own channel?
That's coming.
Where's your channel?
Dean. It's
come
in the works.
Get with this.
You can't rely on
they never guy. Leave me alone for that, do they?
I saw the Friday fish facts, or fun facts.
Oh, that was okay too, yeah.
You've got like 150 videos worth in your fish room alone.
Yeah.
You do?
Dean, I like your videos better than Corey's.
Woo! Oh, don't say that on camera.
The boss watches. There's cameras all over the place with microphones.
Fire!
That's good. Let's put him in the 90.
Oh, that would be awesome.
Hey, Jimmy.
Yeah?
I'm putting money on that because that's Monster Ray and nothing too small in there.
Okay.
So that's what really
we should put him in here.
Right?
Right?
Catch him out of there, though, Dean.
Monster Ray.
That's my thumbnail.
I need one of those lights, by the way.
They break fast.
I know.
Yeah, they didn't last.
I love them. The vivid.
Mine lasted 6 months.
This tank will take all this water easy.
It's not a novel joke. I just don't want to trip.
Oh, it's a little colder than mine. They're shivering.
That's got some good color. You know, the ones that I bought that were babies from here. It's just so good. They grew up to be that big right there.
And then what did you do with them?
They are breeding right now. They don't stop breeding.
That's one thing mine aren't doing. Mine aren't breeding right now. Get out of the bag, guy.
Yeah, look at that light.
Wow, that light does it.
Whoa,
right,
that's
there.
Intense.
All right, so what's the next process? You got to make a tag for it.
A tag? So we're going to have to go to the label maker. I'm going to have to type it in, and then I'm going to have to scrape the glass on the tank to make sure there's no water spots underneath it. And I just peel the label and put it on.
Let's see that.
Yeah. You're in the label maker, and you would turn it on, clear all the settings, and you just punch in the name and how much they are and print the tag.
Easy enough. All right, guys. Hope you guys liked the video. Make sure you hit the dislike button, and have a good day.